loss of four. Now third down. And they'll add a DB in the secondary here on third and 14. Now Roethlisberger. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. Here we go on fourth down with Roethlisberger. And he finds Cook. And he's going to have the first down, yardage to the 35. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They'll come out in the pistol. Now Roethlisberger on first down. Sammy Coates has it complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So the offensive unit called the TO. And now we are ready to resume play. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the right hash, this from an even 40 yards out. And Gostkowski's kick is good. And that cuts the lead down to just three, 20-17. So a field goal here, they're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good, because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
This will be taken about the 12. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And with time running down, they go down to a knee. So we've come upon halftime here in week. All right, hang on. We'll jump over halftime. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 7 yards there on the first down screen play. On second down, here's Roethlisberger. And this one is incomplete. Sammy Coates, the intended target there. And it's third and short. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. They come out with one back and three tight ends. And he fires one, but incomplete.
Holding offense.
And the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. They'll indeed go for it with Roethlisberger. And he comes back with one complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it.
Looking for Lockett, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys will take over at the 20. Offense here ready to take over. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
And this is what here? Incomplete, they say. Looked like it was intercepted, but he apparently did not get the 2 feet down in bounds. Well, they brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on 3rd and 3.
A good call.
He's got his man on the crossing route. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And now they're in the hurry up. On 1st and 10, it's Roethlisberger. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. It's a gain of 24 that time. And it's good enough for an Arizona first. On 1st down, it's Roethlisberger. That is caught at the 7. That one goes for 24 yards. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Now Roethlisberger, and he will score. Touchdown, Cardinals. Ben Roethlisberger taking it in. And the Cardinals have taken the lead.
That was not a designed run. It was supposed to be a pass, but it turned into an exceptional run. What a scramble for a touchdown.
So the drive there. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take...
And Big Ben intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by Tony Jefferson. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
But I think it's safe to say...
So we're back to a 1-point game now as the kickoff comes. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And complete right side to Cook. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. And the offense moving quickly to the line. One quarter remains here as the regulars back now in Los Angeles. And we've got a dandy here. A 1-point game as we begin the 4th. Now Roethlisberger on 1st down. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be 2nd down. 2nd down here after the incomplete pass.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion, and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
And they're going to hurry back to the line now. To throw here, Roethlisberger. Wide open receiver complete. Oh, no, he lost the football. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they thought they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Roethlisberger, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Here's Roethlisberger. It's caught. Lockett. Tyler Lockett. He's at the 40. 20. 10. Touchdown, Cardinals. Tyler Lockett hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. Good pass, clean catch, and a house call there on the fly route.
And not that much room to operate. So that tells you about his acceleration. We always talk about being able to go from 0 to 60 real fast. Took him less time than that to get to top speed and complete that play.
So we're back to a one-point game now as the kickoff comes. Second down, here's Roethlisberger. And this is Cook with a grab. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
You know the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
Bet you're going to tell me. Good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first is good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. They'll look to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense. But when you add to it, you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit, hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the fourth quarter. Got to feel pretty good as a defense.
And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. Pass the 20. Touchdown, Cardinals. A big play there. 85 yards. And the Cardinals have taken the lead here in the fourth.
and touchdown and congratulations and zero relaxation ahead of them, right? Way too much time on the clock for them to start celebrating.
Yeah, part one is done, but now on the sideline, you can already see them scrambling down there. They're getting those defensive guys ready.
Yes, you have to get those guys ready, and you also have to talk to your special teams guys. Make sure the kickoff is exactly what you want and cover it well.
Now Roethlisberger, and it is incomplete, so they can't convert for two. And now the... Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And
now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. He's back to throw. And he can't hang on to it. That would have sealed him. Instead, second down.
Well, an incomplete pass certainly doesn't look like a good play. For the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's got to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction.
Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So here we go, first and 10 now. Back to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
Back to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. He'll look to throw, and he can't hang on to it. That would have sealed him. Instead, second down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
The one running back is Gurley. Here's Roethlisberger. And Cook has it, left side. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. In the red zone this time. Roethlisberger. That's caught at the 1. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Sammy Coates with 7 seconds remaining. And the Cardinals have taken the lead here in the fourth.
I think what we just saw in that drive, partner, is great practice, preparation, and poise. Not only did they score with little time left for them to retaliate, they chewed up enough time along the way while still getting the yardage they needed. That was an impressive drive.
Very methodical. Now, barring something crazy on the kickoff, they've got... Well, Charles, exciting to the very end. That's what we just saw in this game. Final play there, had it in the red zone, but anytime you're outside of the 10, that's tough trying to draw up a final play to get in, and they couldn't do it.
It certainly is. So what they were looking for was, you know, extra time. Too bad it's not FIFA soccer, right, where you get a little bit of extra and you get a chance to run up a couple more plays and maybe get closer and take that last shot into the end zone.
So for the Cards, they will indeed finish over 500 at 9-7. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for Los Angeles, this loss will mean they finish the season right at 500 at 8-8. And they'll get the extra week to think about this one as they return to action in 2 weeks' time. So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. From Los Angeles, so long, everybody.
Scouting points are earned every week. Make sure you use all of your points. A portion of your remaining points will be lost when you advance the week.
Compound. Soon as it's seen it, I swear it, I mean it. My members go quicker than Vomino's. He he in jail. Everyone falling like domino. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that they with this. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that they with this. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist, looking that, feeling that, flicking that wrist.
Logic. Clockwise, counterclockwise, realest in the top five. Other four ain't rapping. I'm just repping for the side.
Yeah,
that's coastlines, Panama for the boat rides. Worth billions, and we ain't even need showtime. Just money counters and kitchenware, condo with a in there. We got rich in there. Been a trophy since Hawaiian Sophie, Curry over Kobe. We shooting Splash Brothers with the add in soda. Good fellas to my Aureliotis. Shades of blue, I bet you. Let the sky fall, let it rain on you.
Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that they with this. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that they with this. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist, flicking that, feeling that, flicking that wrist.
Made it all the way to the wild card round. Remember, the playoffs are single elimination.
Fumble, this offense will get another shot at it as they quickly head back onto the field.
Hey,
Play clock winding down. Now Roethlisberger to throw. Throws a quick hitter on the slant. That's complete. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. On second down, here's Roethlisberger. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. A solid gain of 15 yards, and the sticks move.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends are creating so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost 9 there. That's really going to set him back for second down. Bend to throw again. And complete right side to Cook. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
And the Panthers bring in their nickel set as they try to defend here on third down.
5 defensive backs. On third down, Roethlisberger. Over the middle, it's Jared Cook. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Now we're going to get a stoppage here as we've got an injured Cardinal on the field. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on 4th and 10. Here we go on 4th down with Roethlisberger. He's got Lockett. It'll be a gain of 16 for number 16. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. They go play action here on 1st down. And he finds a man on a crossing route. Touchdown, Cardinals! Tyler Lockett, 41 yards. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. So quick on the spin.
He's spinning, man.
And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Now the offense lining up 1st and 10. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes...
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Luke Kuechly in there to drop him for a loss on the play.
But there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
They'll lock it with a grab over the middle. They get 9 yards there, and they get a first down.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even add it a little extra at the end with a short run. An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. K'Wan Short in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
17 yards on the pickup there, and also a first down.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
And pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Game clock sitting at 2:02, so they'll get one play before the two-minute warning.
Just looking at it from a defensive perspective, when you break the huddle in the red zone, tight end is one of the guys you've got a key on. Because
he rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover. A reminder, as we did all through the regular season, we'll check in with Larry Ridley at halftime. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of play. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Looks like a nickel set here defensively on third and two.
Yeah, maybe expecting a throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant. And that brings up fourth down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude. But I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. And he comes back with one complete. Give him six on the play, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. To throw here, Roethlisberger. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. It's caught. Lockett. Touchdown, Cardinals! Tyler Lockett with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Play of the half. It's Roethlisberger. And that is incomplete. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup as we send you down to Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Panthers struggled to defend the pass in the first half. The Cardinals didn't do well in that area last week, but they've now turned that weakness into a strength here today. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Now first and 10. Here the pass would be completed into coverage, and he's gone as he sprints into the end zone. They're now on top by four. Cardinals have the football midway through the second. Roethlisberger's under pressure will throw the pick. Panthers will come away with the football. After the INT, offense comes out now. It's Big Ben. Ben Roethlisberger getting out of the pocket, completes the pass. And that connection will lead to a gain of 19 yards. Offense on the field now after the INT. Ben Roethlisberger would find his mark in coverage. It ends up working for a touchdown.
All right, Larry, these two teams back out there as we get set and ready for this second half. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And an excellent return there as he's up to the 35, but make it the 40-yard line.
Well, one thing I know for sure, the standard speech is to treat the game like it's tied. But when you have an advantage, they also tell you, make sure you don't get your foot off the gas. Message received.
So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It'll go as a gain of 12, and it'll give the Cardinals a first down. And quickly, they get to the line. Now Roethlisberger on first down, and they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he'll be out of bounds all the way down at the 6. It's a gain of 21 that time. And the Cardinals are going to have it now, first and goal.
Hey, that was a beautifully executed screen pass. It let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front. Completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space with big guys leading the way. When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now it's Roethlisberger. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Their dangerous wide receiver there to make the grab. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead. Well, it was third and one. I was expecting runs, so much for that. They pass it, they score it.
That had the feel of the head coach telling the offensive coordinator, you've got four downs here. We're going to go for it on fourth down unless there's a disaster on third. Go ahead and take.
Touchdown here to kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. Oh, nice spin.
Oh, that brought back bad memories.
And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. This complete to Lockett. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. They'll get 19 yards there. And the Cards are going to have a first down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They go play action here on first down. Wide open receiver complete. It's a pickup of 19. And that'll be good for an Arizona first down. On first down, it's Roethlisberger. He'll lock it with a grab over the middle. Give him 11 on the gain there, and it'll give the Cardinals a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. They'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. And now they're in the hurry up to throw here, Roethlisberger. His throw caught at about the 5. And a nice gain of 21 yards. On first and goal, Gurley. And he is in for 6. Touchdown, Cardinals. Todd Gurley, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Cardinals will extend their lead.
I know the play ends up in the end zone with one person carrying the ball, but how about that big mass of humanity that guided him to that spot?
Yeah, they got there, but I love the dive. Always a fan of the dive. protection was great. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right?
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. K'Wan Short in there to get him, and that's sack number six for him on the year. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On second down, here's Roethlisberger. And now he'll turn, and off his back foot, he'll heave this deep. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
So third and 15, and an extra defensive back in the game now.
Flooding the passing lanes.
Boy, stays up. Now Ben hit, and he lost the football. It's loose. And fortunately, he's able to reel it back in, but it's going to go down as a big loss here on the play. First down, Newton. Caught on the left side by Benjamin. He'll get 17 yards there. And it'll be a Carolina first. So the offense has it first and 10.
That was a nice completion on an out route. And those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
From the red zone now, Newton. And Dixon over the middle. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Dixon, an 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead. And they're able to cut the deficit to 12. Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the Cardinals hands team able to secure the football. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time, you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. He'll throw underneath for Gurley. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Now Roethlisberger on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. On second down, Roethlisberger. And this one caught by Coates. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion. Now Ben on third and long. Bryant with a catch right side. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. And they're going to speed things up here. Here's Roethlisberger. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
Hey. 4 down.
Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. And he can't corral it. Maybe a big missed opportunity there defensively in the end zone. And now third down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
On third and goal, Roethlisberger eluding the pressure right. And he will score. Touchdown, Cardinals. Ben Roethlisberger taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead. So a court. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. So they're going to go for two. And the coach has decided to challenge this play. He has tossed down the red flag. Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination.
And he's going to be taken down. It's a sack, and they fail on the try for two.
Well, they tried to get...
And whistle blown. A timeout here is taken, and it's taken by the kicking team. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
And the kick goes outside the white line. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They come into enemy territory, and I don't care what the matchup is in the National Football League. You're up like this late in the game on the road. This feels pretty good.
Oh, it feels fantastic. Anytime you get a road victory in the NFL, that's a big-time accomplishment, and to do it this convincingly, that just tears up the script that every home team has, which is nobody comes into our house and pushes us around. They took care of business today.
Yeah, they pushed around, and now the final stages of this one. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Roethlisberger going to throw it. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Second and 10. It's Roethlisberger once more. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. And now the clock will stop as he's able to get up and spike it here. Offense still needing 10 yards, second down. They come out here in the eye. Roethlisberger, and the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Maybe just a lack of concentration there as he couldn't haul it in.
And when you're going across the middle like that, you know, he's running that drag route, you are conscious of all the bodies and the traffic in there. But let's face it, if you're going there, you might as well come down with the football and absorb whatever else happens after that.
And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it with Ron. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. And they'll get set here looking for the two-point conversion. Roethlisberger looking to throw. And this one incomplete. So they went for the two. They don't get it. So unable to throw it in for two from the two. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending it?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage. Put your heels on the goal line.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel-down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now, to put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Oh, Roethlisberger gonna throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about five or six plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's gonna hurt.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. Charles, we've seen them target one of their main weapons time and time again. Maybe they went to that well too many times there.
Yeah, and it's so difficult to determine how many times is too many, because how many times have we seen a team go and play and say, until they stop us, we'll keep going. Well, they got stopped on that one, and it cost them 6 points.
This will be fielded at the 8. We're hitting the end of this one, and it looks to probably be the final play. The one running back is Gurley. Now a play fake here on first down. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field, and it's incomplete. Still throwing to the very end, but now this game is over. They said beginning of the season they wanted to get past the wild card round. Well, they just got past the wild card round.
How about that, being able to put the big check marks up in the locker room, right? Get, you know, get to the wild card game, check, got that done. Win a wild card game, big check. Now you've got to go ahead and set your sights higher. There is a bigger prize out there, and they still have an opportunity.